Dogumentary TV, producing the best breed documentaries on YouTube.
Hi, I'm Brad Anderson with bradanderson.org. A Bully Kutta is a dog breed from the Punjab region of India and Pakistan, and was at one point used for hunting. They're also used for guarding, and they're also used for fighting. I came across the breed just doing research. The Bully Kutta is a breed that's kind of has a buzz among the big dog community. And they sparked my interest because they're not a pedigreed dog. They don't have pedigrees. The people that breed them know their lineage, and they do their best to breed them based on their lineage, but you don't get a proper pedigree with them. So I've owned two Bully Kuttas. The first one I imported from India, from the Punjab region. Unfortunately, she passed away. The second one that I own now is Xena. I got her from my friend in California who runs Bully Kutta International. So far, she's been, a very nice, wonderful. So I wanted a Bully Kutta, but like many of the breeds that I own, I wanted one to experience them for myself. With all dog breeds, especially the big ones, especially the fighting ones, there's a lot of breed hype, especially online. And I kind of have made it my personal mission to own these obscure breeds and experience them for myself so that I can kind of weed through the hype and get to the reality of owning them. In owning the Bully Kutta, I've learned that they are a very soft breed, a handler soft breed. A handler soft dog is a dog that will tend to overreact to corrections from the handler. And it doesn't just have to be corrections. It can be if you step on their foot by mistake, they'll get their feelings hurt and be offended about that. I think there's an argument for handler soft dogs. The larger Mastiff breeds and the more aggressive breeds tend to be handler soft on purpose because it makes it easier to control them because they're more willing to listen to their handler and respond to their handler. Whereas a handler hard dog will be more difficult to get to a response from and to get them to listen to you. Handler soft dogs are dogs that you wouldn't want to use a shock collar on or something like that. You could really damage your relationship with the dog. Handler hard dogs, you can shock them all day long and they just let it roll off their skin. And German Shepherds are an example of a pretty hard handler hard dog. So far, my experience with the Bully Kutta is, now mind you, my Bully Kutta is young, so, she can mature and change, but so far she's been very good with my other dogs. She's surprisingly dog social. She, like any Mastiff, especially the fighting and working Mastiffs, they, even if they're great with other dogs, if they get pushed to a point, they will react, and when they react, that tends to be very bad. So, certainly Xena has reacted to other snarky dogs in aggressive ways, but she's remarkably social and tolerant of my other dogs. I've been really pleased with her. She is very suspicious of strangers, and she's kind of quiet and just sits back and watches strangers and people that she doesn't know. She's not overtly aggressive towards them. She will alert bark every now and then, but otherwise she's a very quiet dog. When I first got her, she was pretty horrible with crate training. She'd pee in her crate all the time. She'd scream in her crate. But after a week or two, you know, that went away. And now she's quite good in her crate. She's clean in the house. She's a total love bug with my family. She's great with Chase. She absolutely loves Chase. Chandi, my first bully, could have also loved Chase, my daughter. So that must be I can make the assumption that that could be a bully could have trait, that they're good with children. But I'm sure there's some out there that aren't. But I've been very pleased with her. I from my experience with other dog breeds, I think that she will probably end up being somewhat aggressive towards strangers. I think that the suspicion that she shows now towards strangers will eventually turn into aggression. I've been told that in the Punjab region, the Bully Kutta, the females are prized guardians, and the males are prized for fighting, which is why I wanted females. I'm not a dog fighter. I may own a lot of fighting breeds, but I don't really like the dog aggression and dog fighting. And so, you know, if I can get one particular sex that's less likely to be dog aggressive, I'll go that route. So that's why I went with the females. I would recommend a Bully Kutta as a pet. So far, I have no reason to think that they wouldn't make good pets. I would expect that they'd make the best companion for someone who wanted a dog that was obviously going to be large and powerful and potentially aggressive towards strangers, depending on how much you socialize them. I also think that, you know, the person that owns them as a pet should understand that, you know, there's probably a high incidence of dog aggression in the breed due to them being fought regularly in Pakistan and India now. This is Brad Anderson, and these are my thoughts and observations on owning a Bully Kutta.